What's up? It's your boy Jack back again. Let me talk to you about some Reddit stories real quick. Let's jump right into it. My mom, 52-year-old female, treats me, 24-year-old male, more like a boyfriend than a father and son. Then
we end up asking, will you ever date your mom? And he said, will you date your son? I said, honest truth, yes, I would. Because 19 years, you're the best thing that ever happened to me, and I really want to be with you the rest of my life. And I really want to be with them. It's kind of hard right now, but I don't care what people say, because we're going through a lot right now. We try to keep it a secret, but we couldn't do it no more, because, you know, my other kids found out.
That's nasty, man!
Basically, what he's saying is his mom treats him like a boyfriend. It's always been this way. Growing up, she would tell me about how stressed out she was about the bills and how she wouldn't have enough money to make ends meet. As I got older, it's like she gets needier and needier. She calls me over 2 times a day and texts me so many times to ask where I'm at and what I'm doing.
You know what time it is.
Problem, dude. You know why? Because it sounds like you come from a divorced home or a home where your father was not there. And I say this because this is a epidemic that happens a lot with single mothers. They ruin their relationships with men, and then they act as if their sons are their husbands because they have no male relationships. And they raise their sons up to take care of them. They raise their sons up to be their emotional baggage drop-off place. They raise their sons up to talk to them like females. And it's really, really bad, especially in the Black community, where mama can do no wrong, and mama need my help so I can't be in a relationship, and mama don't really like you because you don't know how to make yams the way she make yams.
You going to school?
Sorry, Mama, I wanted to tell you.
You all gallivant with your fancy foosball friends at school while I'm sitting here all day with nobody to keep me company except Steve?
And all that stuff. This is a really big problem. All right. Says, I can't communicate or tell her how I feel because she'll just argue or make or ask my stuff like why, or ask stuff like why. So it's easy to say that you're doing fine or just tell her where you're at. That's a problem. As a grown man, you need to separate yourself from your parents. There's a reason the Bible says a man should leave his father and mother and cleave, become one with his wife. You got to leave your father and mother. Now you say, well, I'm not married yet and this and that. It's still the act of growing up to leave your father and mother. Get out of the nest. They should know everything you're doing. For one, you don't want to tell them everything you're doing. And you got to make your own way in the world. You got to be responsible for yourself. My dad right now is in his 60s. He don't need to know what I'm doing every day. I talk to him when I can, but I'm a grown man. He's a grown man. The relationship dynamic changes when you grow up. Not only that, but I get the feeling that your mother is treating you more like a husband because she's ruined her previous relationships.
Because I ain't having it, bruh. No way. No how.
Ah, youngster.
Yeah, get your ass up out of here.
Mom! That's right. That's right. Call for your mama.
And she need to go out and live her own life instead of depending on you to be the husband role. A lot of times women will do this when they have failed being a wife. They want their son to act as if their husband. Instead of calling, you know, the father to fix the pipe that's flooding the basement or the kitchen sink or to do some carpentry work, they call the son because they messed up the relationship with the husband and the husband is no longer there because she divorced him and took all his money and snap. She need to get back in a really healthy relationship with a man on her level. By her level, I'm not talking about financially. I'm talking about her age and her maturity. This is a problem in the Black community specifically. It happens a lot. I know people right now who are son husbands. who sit at home and cater to their mother because she's magically sick with the 10th disease that she's had this week.
I've been diagnosed with everything from bipolar disorder, chronic depression. There's a couple other personality disorders I can't even remember. Like, every single person told me different things. A psychiatrist told me one thing. A therapist told me another. One therapist told me, oh no, there's like nothing wrong with you. You're just a girl. Like, coming from a woman therapist. And a psychiatrist was like, you have this, you have schizophrenia, you have this, this, and I was like, what? And put me on meds. So everyone's telling different things. And then Sean.
She just can't cope because she's so stressed out, and now Sean gotta go over there and cater to her needs. That's not your job. That's not your job as a man. You're supposed to do that for your wife, not your mother. And guess what? When you get married, I shouldn't even have to say this, your wife comes before your mom. If it was a burning building and I can only save my wife and my mom, I should save my wife.
She's your queen to be, a queen to be forever, a queen who'll do whatever His Highness desires.
If that's a surprise to you, you probably have the wrong philosophy about life, and your marriage probably won't last. I hate to say it that crazy like that, but that's just the absolute truth. It says, I'm starting to give less of a care now. I ignore a bunch of her calls and texts. You should have been doing that before. And I'm seeing my dad whenever I feel like it. Wait a second, I missed this section about the dad. Sometimes when I try to assert my boundaries and show that I'm getting annoyed, she'll blame my dad and tell me that I'm going to see my dad puts me in a bad mood and how I should see him less.
You're nothing but a liar, a cheater, a deceiver, heartbreaker, and I won't let you back in my life. So I'm taking the house, the cars, the kids, and the dog. I want it all. You're nothing.
That's nonsense. That's controlling. That's manipulative. If you a man, you need more input from your dad because he's a man, not from your mother. A lot of people don't know this. That's a fact. The same sex parent, which is why you need parents of two different sexes, are the ones who can instruct you. Sister, I'm starting to give less of a care now. I ignore a bunch of her calls and texts. I'm seeing my dad whenever I feel like it. Oh, one of my kids is coming to annoy me. Come on, you in the video now.
Can I play?
No, you can't. No, you can't. You can help me with the video. Look at the camera. All right. I'm starting to give less of a care now. I ignore a bunch of her calls and texts. And I'm seeing my dad whenever I feel like it. But it's still getting annoying. It should be annoying because you're not acting as a man right now. You should have been ignoring her texts.
Yeah,
that's right? You should have been annoying her, ignoring her text because as a man, you need to separate yourself. No. Yes. No. Yes. You gonna be talking to your mommy like that and asking her everything when you get grown?
Stop saying that.
Okay, I'll stop saying that. I'm gonna stop saying everything. All right, thank you guys for watching. Subscribe if you want more advice. Don't be a mama's boy. Don't give in to that nonsense. Stop being a son, husband. Find a real wife. And if you have that much of a need to take care of a woman, take care of a wife instead of taking care of your mom like that. She's overstepping her boundaries, and you need to put that back in place. Right, Zachariah?
Yeah.